喂，你好。
啊，不是
哎。小狗跑出去了。
Well, the answer is pretty big. And this is where we can start talking about something called O'Neill. Gerard O'Neill is a professor of physics at Princeton University who postulated the design for a space colony where people would live on the inside surface of a rotating cylinder to produce artificial gravity.
This has all been simulated in computers, and we're fairly confident that the cylinder will maintain its pressure.
In fact, over here we have the same type of pressure cylinder that O'Neill was theorizing would work in outer space.
So how do you know the entire Earth's atmosphere with the pressure inside
of
the atmosphere?
You
have to
look at
that. Let's go
back
and
look
at that.
Let's go back and look at that.
Hey, so maintaining a 24-hour cycle is critical to human health.
The idea is that you could build very large, self-contained habitats in space, that you could put an ecosystem inside, and that you could have hundreds of thousands, perhaps, of people living in space in a self-sufficient, self-contained spacecraft environment. It's something that is on the scale of what you would need to launch to the stars, that propulsion system level is the way we turn it up.
They're calling it the Ark. It will be a cylinder, 15 miles long and 2 miles across. It's roughly 4 times the size of Manhattan.
Scientists at Starship City say that the ship may hold up to 250,000 men. But no scientist or government official is answering the next question, and that is, who gets to go?
There's a death sentence on planet Earth, an inescapable fate with destruction. Humanity mounts a desperate effort to escape the only home we've ever known. We must build a vast ship and fly it to the stars. We must evacuate Earth.
Yeah!
To me is the big question. How do we select the people that do?